Hello everyone, we're gonna go ahead and get started with our cryptography module. This is one of the most important and fundamental modules in information security, as it introduces some of the basic concepts underlying secure communication and secure data storage. We will begin with introducing some basic terminology that is used in the crypto world, ranging from cryptography to key, plain text, ciphertext, and so forth. Now, before delving into it, I want to spend a few words on the motivation as to why encryption and cryptography are very important. As you know, information is now shared mostly over the internet, and this information is shared, therefore, on channels that are insecure, because it's very easy to actually access the access information that is shared across this non-dedicated and shared medium. Therefore, cryptography tries to address the most basic problem, that is to ensure the secure communication over channels that are insecure. So there are two main goals. One is related to privacy and confidentiality, and this is the most obvious, but also there are problems related to authenticity, so how to ensure that the communication is not altered, tampered with, and so forth. The field of cryptography provides a set of tools that allow us to actually address both of these concerns. Here you can see a simple example of a simple crypto protocol. You can see that the idea is very simple. We have some plain text that we want to protect, that we want to encrypt, we want to hide and scramble so that it becomes different from the original content. So in this example, you can see that my plain text is fire. This is the word that we want to hide. We want to make it so that when and if it is intercepted by some non-authorized user, it's not readable. So our plain text is going to work through the process of encryption. The encryption algorithm is essentially a protocol, a set of steps, that transforms our original plain text into the ciphertext. In this case, what we are using is what is called a simple replacement or simple substitution. We are substituting every single letter of the word using a key of 5, which means that for every letter, let's say the plain text is fire, we have F, which is replaced with the letter that is five positions right on the English alphabet. So the result is KNWI. If we want to reobtain from the ciphertext the original plain text, we can just move back and execute our decryption algorithm. The decryption algorithm will transfer the ciphertext into the plain text. How does it do it? It basically proceeds by inverting the set of steps executed during the encryption algorithm. So instead of shifting right, it will shift left in the alphabet in this case. And this is just a simple example of a very simple crypto protocol So in the previous slides, I've introduced several terminology, several words, new words. So I want to explain some of them more clearly. First off, we started off with the word fire, which is called or referred to as plain text. The result of the encryption process is our ciphertext. Ciphertext depends on two important aspects, and these are the algorithm and the key. These two components, which we will discuss at length, are fundamental for the transformation process from plain text to ciphertext. Essentially, what we want to do is to transform and make not legible some plain text, some information that needs to be protected from unwanted eyes and unwanted ears, if you want. Now, the first question I'd like to ask to you is whether or not, and this is important to understand the basic of cryptography, whether or not the encrypted text is visible using sniffing over a network. I ask you all to reflect on this question and see if you can come up with an answer. So the answer, in case you were not sure, is actually yes. The ciphertext is visible over density over the channel of communication. But its most important property is that it's not legible. It's not carrying any useful information for a user who doesn't have, or a user or any entity who doesn't have knowledge of the algorithm and the key being used for encryption. So, again, we have talked about this encryption algorithm. So, what is the encryption algorithm? I like this definition reported here because it's simple, but it really gets the main point. It's a sequence of steps that change the plain text to ciphertext. It is important to mention that there exist many encryption algorithm. Some are very simple and some instead are extremely complex. Modern cryptography is based on extremely complex mathematical properties and operations. But we will see some of the fundamental steps that are used in almost all encryption algorithms. The reverse process is decryption. Decryption consists of going from the encrypted message to the plain text. So the final component that I would like you guys to take a close look at is the key. The key is what makes our encryption process unique. Essentially, your encryption process depends on, as we mentioned earlier, two components, the algorithm and the key. The key is a parameter that is used as part of the algorithm to decrypt or encrypt a message. It is actually encoded as a unique bit string, but in these examples that we will see, we are referring to natural language, so therefore we're referring to the English language, and we have a number of we will use just simple words and so forth, not in digital form, but they are actually represented in bit strings. So remember that in order to protect secrecy of the plain text, some properties need to be satisfied. And one of them is that, of course, as we said, the ciphertext is visible, the plain text is secret, and then we are left with the algorithm and the key. What about them? Well, I can tell you that, of course, the key is usually considered secret. And what about the algorithm? The encryption and decryption algorithms, are they public or private? Those algorithms, as a matter of fact, are public. There is a class of cryptographic algorithms that are usually kept secrets, but the ones that are most widely used, the standards, are public, so therefore known to each other. Hence, you can see that it's very important to protect our key, because the key is the main tie between ciphertext and plain text. If an attacker wants to launch an attack and wants to try to decrypt some ciphertext that has obtained, he already has the ciphertext, he has the algorithm, because the algorithm is assumed to be known, so all he misses is the key. Hence the importance of developing strong algorithms with strong keys, as we will discuss at length. And this is it.